Thank you very much. It's a great honor for me to be here today. I would like to introduce myself very shortly. I came through a very low level process in terms of my capacity as a human being. I did my diploma in Awasa University. I was blessed by the government to do like commerce and in Addis Ababa. I'm not a city girl. And I said I want to go to Awasa. My twin brother is an engineer. I wish he would be here. He told me, why do you want to be an agriculturalist? I said, it's not agriculture. But I love the song, Awasa Ale Shiri Shiri Jayoshi. I am not a Zen, I'm not a man, but I want to see that top. And Awasa is in my heart is in Awasa, really. And I wanted to bring it to the reality and responding to the reality, the innovation factor for gaining food security. We are operating in two drivers, the left and the right driver. The left one is, or either one of them are on the business driver, which is a dominant factor. The other side is the food security, where we have the majority voiceless people and never a little heart, where we came from also. Greetings from Nakane University. We are located in the tip of the north, representing the drier areas, nationally mandated, representing the northern cluster. We are very much preferred in terms of partnership. You are welcome to come and visit us and to take it to the mountainous areas. So I am now representing these people. Population, mountainous area, 88% of total population lives in Ethiopia, in mountains. It's a majority. 95% of the production comes from the mountainous areas. Ethiopia is very known for food cuisine. Most tourists came to enjoy our food. I hope those of brothers and sisters who came from diaspora, they are continuing enjoying your food, isn't it? So this came and innovated from these mountainous people. So you know, we are source of this resistance, quality. 6 out of 8 global origin is found in the mountains, and Ethiopia is one of those. We are a reason for helping the growth areas like USA has been really reverting its barley agriculture because one gene resistant from Ethiopia was introduced. Otherwise, they were losing like more than 25 million USD per year. So what is the paradox? A paradox is people became poorer in the mountainous area. The shift of agricultural system from market orientation coupled with cash crop. I, as a person who used to work in the Oromia region, Amhara, Tigray, as agriculturalist, was based both in the northern shore, the Bebrahan and Shono and Tigray. And I observed that the farmer's environment is different from the breeder's environment. There is no common to adapt the technologies that we release, especially for indigenous crops like barley. I was born relatively in a plain, hot climate, but I'm a mountainous person because of my profession, assigned by Ethiopian Agricultural Research as a barley breeder. Here, Dr. Sebeka is here, my previous boss. You see, what happened was, I failed for 10 years to deliver technology to the poor farmers due to genotype environment interaction. The differential response in the mountainous area is an immense. And I frustrated. Most of my friends moved to the central part of Ethiopia, and I have to ask for some transfer from north to the central part. Technology failure not in Tigray, in Amhara, in other parts like Harargay, where I used to work as development agents. I want to answer this question, but I was frustrated. I must be honest with you, because I wanted a change in this area as part of the thematic Ethiopia 2050. We have high number of population in the mountain. There is no investment. It's unbalanced intervention towards high volume. High number of undocumented migration. Agriculture is feminized in the mountainous area. I like one of the presenters said, Ethiopia gets poor because of educated people. Yes, indeed. Unless we moved out of box, we continue becoming poor. So, one Italian professor I met, he was an inspiring factor for me. He told me in his report, the view goes beyond any possible description. I believe that nobody should die without visiting Tigray, a crop closest to God. He was impressed, but I was not impressed. I don't like, you know, I always, you know, لمن كذي هلا كان يتفطر لمن كذي تفطر ده ما عمل موسيقى يتزتا موسيقى يا كفا على كاكسنا Then I started to read a report by American botanist Harlan in 1923 when he visited Ethiopia as part of his global expedition. He was impressed and he said, but somewhere there are plant breeding people in Ethiopia. He was impressed on the diversity. He is the one who gets recognition for the farmer's knowledge. None of scientists in the world until 2000 never reported and recognized farmer's knowledge. Then I have to follow this one. I have to find out, do we have farmer breeders? Yes. I found a person, very energetic, recognized as community silverback. To his own right, he had his own varieties. To make it short, we are also following the farmers in the highlands. The life expectancy of mountainous people is more than 100 years. Physically, they say, we are what we eat. Mentally, we are what we think. So we said we have to push quality. And I started breeding for quality. And I was very successful to introduce high beta-glucan iron zinc varieties. This is the one on the left side of your view, the one introduced as improved variety. The one on the right side was a farmer's variety. So what miracle it is? Then I have to make every herb, holota, debrebrahan, fala, we have a diverse interaction. And now I have six varieties addressing the mountainous areas. No more blanket recommendation. They need diverse genotypes. They need diverse criteria. And the farmer's knowledge was, for the first time in the club, when they want what is really the role of the woman, we couldn't find practical experiments and practical reasons. Here it is. This is a special variety with high beta-glucan iron zinc. This variety which draws its own. And this factor was really selected by a woman farmer because it reduced their workload when they process it. And this is, you know, we were really on the top to present this practical experience throughout the globe that there are immense knowledge by a woman. And this is the transgressive segregant out of our crossing. We don't have any external product. A crossing made with two materials only, a single cross. You can find, you know, someone said, Dr. Sasuna said, the energy currency. The genotype currency is more important. You know, people, when they see my plot, they say, is it really a result of single cross? Yes, it is. And some of senior researchers in agriculture said, we have never seen this kind of bounty in that part of Ethiopia.